We're going to go over the principles of linear perspective, and I'd like to start by giving you a sentence that I think will bail you out of a lot of perspective difficulties if you memorize it. We're going to go through this, define the terms, and that will get us started in linear perspective. Parallel lines, if they recede, appear to converge at a vanishing point on the eye level line. Parallel lines, of course, are lines that never converge. That's why I've written that they appear to converge. So parallel lines are lines like these two silver bars here, or the top and bottom of the chalkboard. If they were extended all the way out in either direction to the end of the universe, they would remain the same distance apart. That's what parallel means. And so we're saying that they appear to converge. That's the basic principle of linear perspective. What does it mean to say if they recede? This is the acid test of whether you understand the idea of linear perspective. If parallel lines recede from your picture plane, that means that they're going to converge at a vanishing point. So we need, in order to really understand perspective, we need to understand the idea of a picture plane. A box here. The picture plane, you'll be glad to hear, is something that the artist gets to decide on. However, that also makes it a little bit difficult to understand what a picture plane is. When the people who invented linear perspective finally figured out the rules of it, they did it by apparently putting up a piece of glass in front of the object or the scene that they were drawing and drawing it right on the glass. And that's how they figured out that parallels converge at vanishing points on the eye level line. So I'd like you to imagine that piece of glass as being your picture plane. So you can imagine if you're drawing on a pane of glass right in front of you, that if you moved your head at all while you were drawing, I'm tracing the things I see on the other side of the room here in my imagination, if I move my head at all, the objects that I'm drawing move away from the lines that I've drawn, right? So linear perspective requires that you think about that picture plane and you think about keeping your head in lined up perfectly with it and not changing it. The picture plane is always the imaginary surface that you're drawing on. You're really drawing, of course, in your sketchbook or on a canvas or on a drawing pad or something like that, but you're imagining in your imagination that you're drawing on this imaginary sheet of glass. That's the thing we're talking about when we say if your parallel lines recede, it means do they recede from that imaginary pane of glass? So, here's what we're talking about, and a real rectangular solid. So if you, the viewer, are setting up your imaginary picture plane parallel to the front surface of this object, then we've got some lines that don't recede from it, right? If your picture plane is parallel to this front surface, then these lines are not receding from it. They're marching along parallel to it, however far you extend them, along with the verticals. The verticals also are not receding from your picture plane, but are going along parallel to it. The set of lines that is receding from your picture plane is this set that goes back into space, and those are the ones that will converge at a vanishing point on the eye level line. I'm gonna set that box there, parallel to your imaginary picture plane, so that we can draw it in a minute in one-point perspective. I just want to go over, we won't worry about vanishing point yet, because that will become obvious, but I want to go over the concept of the eye level line. The eye level line means the place where eye level, which is really a plane, intersects with your picture plane. Obviously, when two planes intersect, you have a line, right? So, and we're talking about the artist's actual eye level. Actual may sometimes mean imaginary. If you're drawing from your imagination, you can still imagine an eye level. Or if you're drawing from observation of life, it could be a real physical place in a room where you're standing. So the way that I typically ask my students to imagine this is if you're in the room and the room fills up with water to the level of your eyeballs, everything that's wet is below your eye level, everything that's dry is above your eye level, everything that's floating or right on that line is on your eye level plane, and where that plane intersects that imaginary piece of glass that you are calling your picture plane, that's your eye level line. If it seems confusing, maybe it'll get clearer as we talk. In one-point perspective, which is the simplest case, and that's what we're going to start with today, we're going to imagine an eye level, and I'm going to put it right about at my eye level just so that you remember that it is the artist's eye level. But obviously, if I were drawing on paper, it would be down my lap. If I were drawing on an easel, it might be over here somewhere. If I were imagining that I had a really high eye level, it might be way off my canvas. Or if it were really low, it might be out of my canvas at the bottom. Right now, we'll put it right there. I'm going to label it eye level line because we're going to have a bunch of other lines in just a moment. And we're going to start with a rectangular solid, kind of like this, that is parallel with one face, parallel to an imaginary picture plane that is vertical. So I'm going to draw that case here. I'm going to draw the front of that box. And it's, I'm trying to draw a little kind of cubish box sort of like that. If this angle here is a 90 degree angle, and if your box that you're drawing is a rectangular solid, then you are now in a one-point perspective situation. Obviously, the box is below my eye level. I've sort of arbitrarily put it a few inches below the eye level that I've drawn. And I'm going to find a vanishing point on this eye level line where all these lines that go back and recede from the picture plane are going to converge. If I see, and I'm looking at my box the way you are now, if I see the right side of my box, it means that my vanishing point must be over here on the right. If I see, I move myself over, so I see the left side of the box, that means the vanishing point is on the left. Just for fun, let's say, let's put our box here so that you see the left side of the box, and we're going to put the vanishing point here on the left. I'm just making this up. This is fairly arbitrary. And now I'm drawing lines from the vanishing point. Let's even make this a little straighter, Kathy. That go to the corners of the box, right? This vanishing point gives us these angles here. It makes the box get smaller as it goes back into space. Now, obviously, a box is not really infinite. It doesn't go all the way back to infinity at the back of this eye level plane. But we can cut it off wherever we decide. These lines, of course, this is one of the set of verticals that we get for free, that we don't have to make converge. And wherever that vertical hits this line, this is one of the set of horizontals. And I'm going to try to make my vertical is really vertical. I can really make that fairly vertical today. Let's make it a little more than that. There we go. Something like that. Okay, there's a vertical line, we'll say, and there's a horizontal line, which finish my box. So this is the information that eye level and vanishing point gave me. These are imaginary lines, of course, but they matter. I'm gonna make them dotted so you see that. They matter because they are helping my viewers see, first of all, that my box is parallel to my picture plane with one face, that it's below eye level because it allows me to draw the top of the box, and that it is to my right so that I see the left side of it. In one-point perspective, if you were to draw a drawing entirely in one-point perspective, what you would be telling your viewer is that every rectangular solid in the drawing was lined up parallel to a picture plane, with one face parallel. In other words, all parallel to each other. Say if you went into an office where all the desks were parallel to the walls and parallel to each other. or if you lined up a set of children's blocks and that they were all parallel to each other and parallel to your picture plane. You might draw a city block like that. You might draw the hallway here at Cascadia like that. It is pretty easy to find situations where everything is lined up with each other. They're fairly artificial, but they exist. And it's important to see that if you choose to show objects with their faces parallel to the picture plane, then you may only use one vanishing point for all of them. Think about it. I'm going to draw a box up here. It's above eye level. It's levitating somehow, or maybe falling in, right? Whoops. I could have been straighter. I'm trying to get these as straight as possible because this point gives us these angles, and if you don't get the lines pretty straight, you don't get the right angle here. So I'm going to say this box must be this deep, looks like that. We can see that this box is above eye level because we can see its bottom, which is always a sign that something is about to fall on you. And we can see that it's also to our right because we see the left side of it. If I wanted to draw a box over here, say a box that's both above and below my eye level, like maybe a refrigerator or something, right? Something that goes up above my eye level but also extends down to the ground. I have to, if I draw it with a right angle in the same drawing as these critters here, then it has to share their vanishing point because of our rule. Parallel lines, if they recede from our picture plane, have to converge, appear to converge, at a vanishing point on the eye level line. So these lines, they go back into space. It's going to make my refrigerator arbitrarily go back about that far. Of course, again, these are imaginary lines here going back into space, just like these. These are imaginary lines, but they give me these angles here, which is very important, right? So that's the principle of one-point perspective. If these lines are parallel to each other, and they are, because they're all horizontal, then these lines are parallel to each other, and they are, because they're all vertical, then these lines, which are so unparallel to each other in my drawing, are actually, in real life, if you think about it, they have to be parallel to each other, and therefore, they share a vanishing point. Okay, that's how one-point perspective works in theory.